Welcome to this channel, myself Dr. T. Indranath. Today in this video, I will talk about one of the most important cancer in India is oral cancer and its precancerous lesion. So what are the precancerous lesion? There are three important precancerous lesion is the leukoplakia, erythroplakia and hairy leukoplakia. And if you are a male and you have a habit of tobacco chewing, you are very much prone to develop this precancerous lesion and as well as cancer. So before starting the video, if you are new to this channel, subscribe the channel, share the video with your friends. And now, what is leukoplakia? Leukoplakia is a white patch, you can see in the picture. It is a white patch and most common site of this patch is in the oral cavity, anywhere in the oral cavity, but mostly we can see in the buccal mucosa or in the floor of the mouth. And size, if you see, it is always more than 5 millimeter in size. And it can be multiple or it can be single. And appearance we all see in the picture, it is a white appearance and it is sharply defined border. Okay. Now you can see the next condition is called erythroplakia. Erythro means red, plakia means black. So it is also the similar condition as of leukoplakia, but it is red, so we call it erythroplakia. The basic difference of this leukoplakia and erythroplakia is that the erythroplakia has higher chance of turning into malignancy. Okay. Now, if you are a male of 40 to 70 years, you have a habit of tobacco chewing, so you are very much prone to develop oral cancer and precancerous lesion. So, always you check in the oral cavity, in the mirror, or in a dentist or in a ENT specialist, you can check it out whether you have developed all this condition or not. Now, if you see the picture, the microscopic picture of this leukoplakia and erythroplakia, we can see here, and both the picture is almost same. Here we can see the hyperkeratosis or acanthosis in the epithelial layer, and if you see the subepithelial area, there are some inflammatory cell like lymphocyte and macrophage. In erythroplakia, one thing is more important, it is the vascular dilatation. Because vasodilatation is there, so there are more blood flow and it gives the reddish color. That's why you call it erythroplakia. So this is the basic difference between the leukoplakia and erythroplakia. And another important condition is called hairy leukoplakia. Means leukoplakia means white patch, but it is hairy, hairy as it is fluffy. Because it, you can see the picture, you can see the picture here, you can see the white color fluffy, and it mostly found in the lateral margin of the tongue. So how we can differentiate between the hairy leukoplakia and leukoplakia is basically by the appearance of this lesion, like fluffy lesion, and site of the lesion in the lateral border of the tongue. And number two important is hairy leukoplakia, always found in the, mostly found in the HIV patient or any other immunocompromised patient. So any patient having the HIV history of HIV or AIDS or any other immunocompromised situation, so you can expect that the condition will be hairy leukoplakia. And in this condition, the most common virus found is the EBV, Epstein-Barr virus. So now basically we have to differentiate between three conditions: leukoplakia, erythroplakia and hairy leukoplakia. And remember, my dear friend, there is another most common and benign condition is there, what we call it, as a aphthous ulcer. Is a very common ulcer, is known as aphthous ulcer, and many of us have suffered from aphthous ulcer, and it is basically developed during any stressful condition, and it is usually in the lower lip, basically in the lower lip, and there will be sharp margin, and there will be depressed skull, and it is very benign, and it will take 10 to 14 days, and it will be totally cured. There will be no residual disformity of the mucosa. So this is the beauty of the aphthous ulcer, and we have to differentiate between the aphthous ulcer and this all the precancerous lesion of leukoplakia, erythroplakia and hairy leukoplakia, which can turn into oral cancer. So this is my humble request. If you are taking tobacco, please try to reduce it. If possible, avoid it, tobacco. Or if you can't avoid the tobacco, please check your oral cavity frequently, at least once in a 6 month or 3 month. You should check it, you should prevent it, because oral cancer is very much prevalent in India and it has a very, very bad outcome. So I hope this video has given you some impression, some knowledge. Please share the video, subscribe the channel. Thank you. Myself Dr. T. N. Devnath signing out. Until we meet again.